स्टूडेंट, टुडे माय टॉपिक इज बफर सॉल्यूशंस। अ फ्रेशली प्रिपेयर्ड सॉल्यूशन हैज अ डेफिनेट वैल्यू ऑफ पीएच। अ सॉल्यूशन व्हिच हैव पीएच बट इट बिकम अनस्टेबल व्हेन केप्ट फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम और ऑन एडिशन ऑफ अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ सम एसिड्स एंड बेस। बट सेवरल केमिकल, बायोलॉजिकल एंड इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोसेसेस रिक्वायर्ड सॉल्यूशन हुज पीएच वैल्यू डू नॉट चेंज appreciably either on the keeping for the long time or on the addition of a small amount of acids and base. Therefore, several solutions have been introduced which are capable of maintaining definite value of pH. So, buffer solution is the solution which do not disturb the pH of the solution. Such solution are called the buffer solution. Or you can say a buffer solution is the solution which maintain its pH fairly constant and is capable of resisting the change in pH on addition of a small amount of acids or base. If we add some acids or base, it maintain the pH of the solution. That is the buffer solution. Or you can say the ability of a buffer solution to resist means what? To stop any change in pH on addition of acids and base are called buffer action. Human blood is an excellent example of the natural buffer. Normal human blood has a pH of 7.4. Blood always maintain this value of pH no matter what type of food we eat. Blood maintain pH by buffer action of the carbonic acid, that is H2CO3, bicarbonate ion, that is HCO3 ion, and CO2. These three are maintain pH in our blood no matter what we eat. Seawater is another example of a natural buffer which maintain its pH around 8.2 by the complex buffer action of various salt present in it. Buffer solution are of two types. First is acidic buffer and second is basic buffer. Acidic buffer, the solution of a weak acid and its salt with a strong base is called acidic buffer. For example, equimolar quantity of acetic acid and NaOH, this solution maintain pH is equal to 4.74. Other example are phthalic acid, when react with potassium acid phthalate, it have 2.2 to 3.8 pH. Formic acid, when react with sodium formate, its pH is 3.7. Boric acid, when react with borax, its pH become 6.8 to 9.2. Now come to basic buffer. This solution of the weak base together with its salt with a strong acid is called the basic buffer. I repeat, the solution of a weak base together with its salt with a strong acid is called basic buffer. For example, equimolar quantity of NH4OH, that is weak base, and NH4Cl, which is come from when NaOH react with HCl. NH4Cl come from when NaOH react with HCl. Both when they have equimolar quantity is the basic buffer solution. Then it is known as basic buffer solution. This solution maintain its pH around 9.25. Now come to the working of buffer solution. First we have discussed about buffer action of an acidic buffer. In order to understand acidic buffer, let us consider a buffer solution containing acetic acid and sodium acetate. That is, this is the acetic acid and this is the sodium acetate. Both release acetate ion, and when this strong acid, they have acetate, and then this acetate when get react with hydronium ion, it forms acetic acid again. So that it is known as common ion effect, as we have discussed earlier. So hydronium ion concentration become less because it combined with the acetate and form acetic acid. And the sodium acetate when added to acetic acid solution, then acetic acid gets suppressed due to the common ion effect, as the solution contain larger number of acetate ion. This acetate ion get react with hydrogen and form the acetic acid. Suppose a few drops of HCl are added to the above solution. In this solution, if we add HCl, the strong acid, which provide hydronium ion and it is free and decreases the pH of solution. The acetate, which is present in the large extent in the buffer solution, immediately combine with the hydronium ion to form acetic acid. Again, the acetate ion with the react with hydronium ion. Hydronium ion release with the HCl. Now it forms acetate and water. So the hydronium given by the acid can trap all the acetate ion, and acetic acid unable to dissociate, and there is no change in pH of the solution. If a small amount of NaOH added to it, then it gives OH ion, and this OH combine with hydronium ion and forms water, that is H2O. Again, removal of hydronium will increase the ionization of acetic acid. That is, when this hydronium ion get react with OH and forms water, then it not suppress the this acetic acid, and acetic acid free to dissociate till the concentration of hydronium ion is related to its original value. Like this, this is the hydronium ion. When get react with OH, it forms water molecule. Thus, all the OH ions given by the NaOH get trapped in the form of unionized water molecule, and there is no change in pH value of the solution. So it may be concluded that an acidic buffer is capable of resisting means what? To stop any change in pH on the addition of a small amount of the acid or base. Now next is buffer action of the basic buffer. Suppose we have the basic buffer containing ammonium hydroxide and ammonium chloride. Like this. This is the ammonium hydroxide and this is the ammonium chloride. Both of it release ammonium ion, and the strong electrolyte, that is NH4Cl, this NH4 get reacted with OH and form NH4OH. In this way, OH ion decreases in the solution. So we have large number of NH4 ion. When a small amount of NaOH is added to this, in the solution, OH ion combined with NH4OH, and formation of NH4OH, thus pH of the solution remain practically unchanged. In this way, this is NH4 comes from buffer solution, and this OH comes from NaOH, and when both of them get combined, then it forms NH4OH. If a small amount of HCl is added to this solution, hydronium ion given by the HCl combine with the OH to form water molecule. Again, that same process happen when we add HCl. So these two molecules, when get reacted with each other, they form water molecule. These two ions, when react with each other, it forms molecule. The removal of OH from the solution causes NH4 to ionize more till the loss of OH ion is compensated. pH remain constant. Thus, basic buffer can also resist to any change in pH on addition of a small amount of acid or base. So, in acidic buffer also and in basic buffer also, pH doesn't change because of the common ion effect. So, my question is for today is, what is acidic and basic buffer? Thank you.